Hello guys, welcome to ControlNet YouTube channel. I'm here today with a new AI video. Today I will show you how to make up QR code using ComfyUI. So I will use the brightness method, obviously. If you don't know what the brightness method is, please watch my previous videos. The first video where I made up a QR code using ControlNet became very popular. Therefore, I would like to thank you to all of you for your comments and likes. Thank you very much. Okay, I'm using automatic 1111 and the ComfyUI on the same machine. And in this video, I will show you how to use automatic 1111 ControlNet extension for the ComfyUI. First of all, we need to make a small change in ComfyUI. We need to copy the path of the ControlNet folder in the automatic 1111 base folder. So I'm gonna show you. Let's start. This is my AI folder, so this is the automatic 1111 base folder, the extensions folder, then there is a ControlNet extension. So only we need to do copy the path and paste the ComfyUI, so ComfyUI folder, extra model paths YAML file. So the file already open in my computer. So only we need to paste or type the path of the ControlNet extension path. So the ControlNet variable. So just we need to do start the ComfyUI. Let's start. I'm starting ComfyUI. Yes, ComfyUI is working. So we can start the create the workflow. My first node, it's going to be a checkpoint loader. Second, obviously the cars handler and our first connection is this. So also I'm gonna change the colors, these nodes, because this is the common pattern. So at the end we can see easily what we changed. So we need an empty image. To connect as latent image. So I'm going to change this 768 because I'm using 768 barcode actually file. Why I'm doing this. So also I'm going to change the color blue. Obviously we need prompts, so we need click text encode pro nodes. So I'm gonna clone it and I'm going to change this. These are prompts. One of negative, and also it's the base point. So I will add primitive nodes, two primitive nodes we need. One of is connect here, and connect here. So this one, or base prompt or positive prompt, and this is the negative prompt. Actually, this is base prompt or positive prompt, I can say. This is negative prompt, so I will change the colors. This is positive and this is negative. Yes. So I'm gonna add reroot here. And also we need to connect. Yes. Okay. I'm doing this change because at the end we can see easily the workflow, how it's working. So this is the also common pattern, so we need to change colors to blue to see our common pattern. Yes. Normally, connecting our prompts to call sampler is enough to run this workflow. So we need to image preview also here. But what we are going to do, so we need to inject the ControlNet workflow in this workflow actually to work. So what I'm going to do, first load ControlNet loader to use. Yes, ControlNet loader. And I need another one because we are using the brightness method. So we need two ControlNets. So this is our first ControlNet model. So I'm going to change. It is the brightness, and this is the tile model. So as you know, so also I'm going to change the title as tile, and brightness. Yes. So another thing, we need to use apply ControlNet. ControlNet, but not the simple one. So we have to use advanced one. So also we need the clone. Yes. Also I'm going to change this workflow color as yellow to see what we are doing, what the ControlNet workflow looking for. So yes, So also we need image loader to load our barcode here. So I'm choosing my QR code. So and change the color yellow. Yes. So only we need to do connect these parts to each other. So first, so this is our first control net. So this is brightness model. So we need to connect this control net here. And also, we need to connect negative prompt here. Sorry, this is negative here, and the positive one here instead of the sampler. So also we should connect our image. So maybe I can delete, and I need to reboot. It shows us how to workflow working actually. Yeah. Also, we should connect image also another control. Let's. So this is our tile control, so we need to connect tile here, and also maybe we can see the connections clear with this, yes. So only we need to do connect these control nets to each other. So then we need to connect our control net output, second control net output to sampler. So it's negative. Actually, so we completed to control net connection, all the workflow. So only we need to see preview image, actually to display the image. So I will connect the, I will add the decoder here. So we need to connect decoder like that. And also change the color blue, and also we need image preview to see the result. As you can see, we have two different workflow. Actually, this is the common pattern. So actually, we have a workflow, but it has two different patterns. So this is the common pattern, and also this is the control net pattern. Then, actually, it's ready to run, but before this, I want to change some parameters in sampler. So I want to use DPMM++2M and also Keras as scheduler. Also, we need some changes on the control net. So this is the brightness, so we need to change strength to 0.25, and we don't need to change these parameters. Also, this is the tile, so we have to change tile model strength is 65, and also we need to add start 35 and 0.75. So actually this is what we did before on the automatic 11.11 control net settings. Only we need to do write a prompt. So I have prompt I used before, so I can use again. So this is my base prompt, and also yes. The workflow completed and it's ready to run. So I'm checking all of them is connected. Yes. Let's run it now and see the result. It will take some time as I'm also recording video. I'll speed up these parts also later. And our workflow starting. So as you know, the green border means this part is working. Actually, I want to cancel this process because so I want to use change my base model because I used it before and I got some good results. It's the realistic vision version 20. So I'm gonna use this model as base model. So and then I start my prompt again. The sampler started. Also, we can see the process on our terminal. So here is the process. Our first QR code generation here. So, yes, workflow has completed the first QR code. Actually, it looks pretty successful. Of course, it's always important to check because this method actually deforms the QR code also. It will be good to make sure that the QR code is still readable as a result of the process. So I'm going to check with my phone. Yes, it's working. So I hope enjoy the video. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to like video and also subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye bye.